Hello guys, I'm going to be showing you guys how to diagnose rod knock sound. For example, your car is making that rod knock sound. You want to know which cylinder is causing that sound. So I'll show you guys how to do that. So what you do is you bring the cylinder. You do all of them and then see which one is bad. So I know it's number 3 is bad, so I'll show you guys number 3. So what you do is you bring the cylinder to the top dead center. It's right here, and then you go a little bit down, and then what you do is right here, hold it here, just hold it there. Okay, now is what you do, you push this down, and then if you feel a play there, then that means that there is a play on your bearing. So have a look, close look, because it's going to go down when I'm going to push on it. See that? You could even hear it. It went down. So I did on every single one of them, 1 to 4. I thought number 1 was bad, but actually number 3 is bad. So when you go down, it went 1/8 of an inch down. Yeah, I'm not sure if you guys can hear it or no, but when I did it multiple times, all of them, but this one, number 3, it goes a little bit down, and then I know that this one is bad. So and then when you're doing, make sure, if you don't have a long extension, make sure you're not using two extension like this, because if you have two extension, they have a little bit play on them, so you think, oh, it has a play, as it will be a wrong diagnosing. Make sure whatever you're using is one piece and it's a solid one. So now we can confirm that cylinder number 3, the connecting rod bearing is gone. So that one has a play, needs to be addressed, replaced, more look into it. So number 3 is bad. That's how you find out which connecting rod bearing is gone. This is my connecting rod bearings. That's cylinder number 1, 2, 3, and 4 down there. So when we did our diagnosis, we find out that number 3 was bad. So here, you can hear and you can see that there's a play there. This just verifies that our diagnosis was right. So you can just diagnose which cylinder has a connecting rod bearing the way I show it. So you don't even need to remove all this. Just this one is to prove that our diagnosis was right. So I'm gonna remove this and have a look inside and try to replace it. Number 1, 2, 3, 4. So number 3 was the worst one. And number 1, I thought the noise was coming from number 1. It wasn't, but you could see it has something there. So that wasn't that good either. So good thing that I replaced all of them. Number 3, number 2, and number 4, they weren't that bad. So only number 3, which was the worst one, and then number 1. Good thing to do all of them.